you're practicing, do you have multiple guitars in different tunings, or do you tune to each of those before each song when you don't practice?
No, I don't change. Asking if I change guitars. Well, tuning, no. I mean, I play one guitar, pretty
so
much.
So you practice all of your dad songs and then go to a standard tuning, or?
Yeah, I can. Change around between tunings pretty quickly. I mean, really, the majority of the songs that I do are either in standard tuning or in drop D tuning. Starting to experiment more with the lower tunings, like that Stevie Wonder song. I had a few songs with C in the bass now. Only a few things in dad-gad tuning. And there are ways around that too. You ever seen one of these partial capos? I have a couple of these up here, and so this is a capo that covers just three strings, and I'm not going to do a song with this right now, but if I put this on in this position here, it's basically holding down an E sus chord. Whoops, I'm still in another tuning here. But in standard tuning, with that capo, that's an E sus chord, which is actually the same as dad-gad tuning a step up. So I just did that bird song in dad-gad tuning. I can also play it in the key of E with this and do almost the same thing. So sometimes if you might see me do this live in other situations, I might actually be playing it with the partial capo, because then I can sort of switch tunings without actually retuning any strings, if that makes any sense. Partial capos are a real interesting tool to play around with in that way. Opens up some other possibilities, which is a good segue into this last song, actually. Which is not a dead song, but a Beatles song. And this capo is a partial capo that's built to cover five strings. And you can use this. This is the way this is often used. I'm putting this at the second fret, covering the top five strings, and then it's leaving sixth string open. So really it's almost the same as playing in drop D tuning, but I'm in standard tuning. I know that this stuff is very confusing to the brain to think about, but yeah.
You might want to mention that because it isn't drop D, when you play above it and cover them, you use standard. Right?
Yeah, that's the beauty of the partial capo is, okay, so I'm in standard tuning. The strings are in standard tuning. I've got the top five strings covered at the second fret. I can play a D chord now, and that sounds like I'm in drop D tuning because I got this low bass string on the sixth string. And yet, as you were mentioning, if I want to play anything up above the capo that doesn't have an open string in it, I'm just playing standard. I am in standard tuning, so I can play all the standard chords. But then if I want that low bass note, it's there. So that's actually a really cool and really practical kind of thing, and something that I use in this song. So I had been fooling around with this partial capo, and I was really wanting to do Dear Prudence, Beatles song that I always loved. And if I'm sure you know the original recording of that, there's a beautiful fingerstyle guitar part on that. But there's also so much more on that original recording of Dear Prudence. There's that incredible grooving bass line. There's great drums, and then there's that gorgeous lead guitar lines, these melodic guitar lines going on in that song. So for me, thinking about doing this song and arranging it, that all got me thinking about how to do some justice to some of these other elements of that. Because to me, to play the fingerstyle guitar part like on the recording, it wouldn't have that same quality. So it got me thinking about the partial capo, and in Dear Prudence, there are these notes ringing in the treble almost through the whole song. Right, which if you're playing that in standard tuning, you gotta hold those strings down the whole time. If you're playing it in the key of D. So my thought with arranging this song is, I wanna have those notes ringing. Wouldn't it be great if I didn't have to fret them? And then my hands would be free to do other things. So in comes the handy capo here to hold down the top five strings of the fifth fret so that those notes are open strings for me now. And then I'm free to do other things. Then I wanted bass notes. I wanted low bass notes. So what I wound up doing on this song is tuning my sixth string all the way down to C. So it's kind of a weird configuration, I know. There actually is a lesson that I wrote for acoustic guitar all about using a five-string partial capo that included a transcription of this version of Dear Prudence. So I got a C in the bass and then this partial capo. Well, here's how it came out, and I wanted to have Wendy again join me for this one. Have a hand for Wendy Rand. So I was arranging this as a solo thing, but also with this trio in mind, with Josh DeCaney on percussion and the Wendy on vocals and also flute. I knew we could do a lot with the vocal harmonies in this song, but then the arranger and me started thinking about these beautiful melodies, George Harrison's beautiful lead guitar melodies. And so what we wound up doing is putting those on the flute to combine with the guitar. And here's what we came up with. Before we just play the song, we just say, oh, we'll just do this and wrap up, and I'll be, I'd love to meet and chat and hang out. I have a whole bunch of stuff that I brought along. The two Grateful Dead DVDs from Homespun, my recordings of my original music, a couple books that I wrote, including interviews with Jerry Garcia and Paul Simon and James Taylor and all these people. But through my work at Acoustic Guitar Magazine, since the very beginning of Acoustic Guitar, I also edited tons of guitar books. And I had a bunch of those that I just thought I would bring over. It's a bunch of lesson books with CDs about blues, flat picking, finger picking, swing. There's an Alex Degrassi finger style method that I edited recently. They're all books that I edited. That I thought I'd bring and make available to you all. And any of the books are $15, and so if you want to check out any of that stuff, please do, and credit cards are fine too. So we've got a little sort of temporary music shop set up over here.